Alright, hey, before we start this video, I just want to explain some things because the vlog is kind of all over the place. So, first of all, on Wednesday we traveled to Minnesota. On Thursday we got there and we went and explored Walnut Grove so we would know our way around for the rest of the weekend. On Friday we got autographs with the stars. On Saturday we hung around Walnut Grove and visited the Plum Creek site. And on Sunday, we got our group photo with the stars and started on our way home. And on Monday, we got home. And that pretty much brings you up to speed. So, just enjoy the rest of this video. And, yeah. That's pretty much all I have to say. So, yeah, and just enjoy the rest of the video.
Okay, hey there, everybody. We are in our first hotel room for the trip. We are in Wisconsin right now, and we'll be in Minnesota tomorrow. So here's our hotel room. Hi, there's a mirror. Oh. Okay. Here's the bathroom right when you walk in. Oh, wait, that's not the right light. What am I doing? All right, here we go. Pretty average bathroom. Yeah, that looks kind of cool. Towels and stuff. Okay. Here's a closet area. Here's our bed. We already put all our stuff in our suitcases. You know, TV, fridge, microwave. Pretty basic stuff. A desk. Chair. And the other bed. And here's our view. Pretty basic view, I mean. Not much to it. There's a water over there. And there's this bug on the outside of the window. I'm not exactly sure what kind of bug that is. Like, and that's that, pretty much. Right?
Wait, listen to this when I sit down.
I don't know if you could hear that, the camera could hear that, but it's like... Well, that's our hotel room. I'll update you when I feel like it. See you later.
I'm pushing Jessica.
Yeah, my princess wave.
Just waiting for our luggage on before doing this. Yeah, my shoe. I just lost
Hello,
my shoe.
Hello, fellow townspeople.
What?
Wait, excuse me.
Oh, you're heavy. Yeah, well, heavier than you. Can I just ride down in the lobby like this?
Thank you. either way are already there, and we've been watching on the Facebook group and stuff like that, so we're pretty excited, and hopefully we might be able to see some stars there early, but we'll just go there and check it out anyways, so see ya.
We're just starting the tour for the museum at Laura Ingalls Wilder Museum.
Did they see it?
Did you read this?
Hold on, I'm getting a video. Alright, this is like what the Braille. Like, this is the Braille Bible. That's what it says or something. It's like, this is what you would have to read. Like, it's just like texture. Like, how on earth can you read that? I guess you can't really tell unless you're like blind. I'm closing my eyes here.
That's not how you read Braille.
I know, but it's just like...
So it says the windows are from the church in Walnut Grove.
The green pan.
What?
On top of the green.
Oh, this was maybe later they don't.
Oh my goodness, this looks old.
Look at the windows.
That stool. Is this all from the original church?
I think so.
Parts of it.
Some of it was donated. Look at these little tiny pews.
Going in the grandma's house. Wait, who's grandma? It says that some of the things in here Laura owned. Wait, so like, what, who Who's grandma? I don't understand. No, like, what? Can you please explain to me what this is? Look at this old stove.
Look at this.
Here, Jeff, I'm a good picture to hold it. Try to talk. I'll turn around.
There's an attic.
Wait, look. There's one right here.
Is this a villa?
I think.
What is this?
Laura's writing desk. Like,
oh. Red letters written by Laura.
Let's go see what this other stuff is out here, too. We can look some in.
There's too much stuff in here. Oh, I can't look at it all.
Okay.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh, that's
nice.
Oh, it's open.
Someone escaped. Someone escaped. Someone escaped. What is this?
Their dugout.
Wait,
like,
what?
Their one, but like what it looked like.
Like, what is a dugout? Can you go in? Where they lived
while he was building their house.
Oh, this is.
This is where they lived while they were building the house.
Oh, this is strange.
So they slept in here, ate in here. Like, I mean, this is the replica.
All lived in here, or is something similar?
I couldn't imagine
living
in here,
but like they lived in a dugout like this. But
wait, what are these?
House replica. What are these?
Jump rope.
Oh, okay, you know what? I gotta get a picture of you girls.
Hey, wait, this is the slate. Well, you can't move any of this. So I was gonna say, like, somebody could just steal this. That would be good.
Okay.
Can I be the teacher?
Wait, rules for teachers. This is really something.
Wait, what?
You're an FP company with me. You're not married during the term.
And there's no chair.
You're not lawyer downtown and ice cream slate. Jessica.
Dry scalp treatment. Dandruff. They have hair tips in here. Sitting in the desk.
Okay, sit down, Jennifer. I'm gonna get a picture of you. Okay, wait. I'll wait a second.
Ready for school?
Oh,
ready to go?
It's okay. Just do it the other way.
Stop.
Okay, we are now on our way to Walnut Grove for the official autographing day. And we're just going through a bunch of farmland again. Get to the actual town, and that's that. We'll be there and meeting the stars today, soon, so I guess I'll see you later.
This is your line, my dear.
Till the afternoon.
We're walking to Nellie's cafe right now. Hopefully there's not much people here. There doesn't seem to be this much, like, much people on this side of town. Eating at Nellie's cafe right now.
I'm gonna sneak in here real quick.
Thank you so much.
So there's my food. We're waiting in line right now. They aren't here yet for like the second autograph thing. They're gonna be here in like 15 minutes. We're in the line for John Jr. That's who the character is. Radames. How do you say his name?
Radames Pera.
Radames Pera. Because it's the shortest line compared to the others. And last time when we went in the shortest lines, it worked. We were able to get the shorter lines like then first, and then go in the longer line for like Alison, Nellie, whatever. And Charlotte Stewart was Miss Beadle, so. That's what we're doing right now, right?
Yeah.
Got that ready. We're giving them each ornament and like a little thank you note, whatever.
We got this at their autograph.
Oh, wait. Nice. Alright, now wait, show your little drawing on the. Yeah, she did all those on the envelope she gave into. That's the design. So we just gotta wait. Wait, oh. Plum Creek site, the dugout site or whatever. Yeah, Jessica and Don are up there. They left without us, apparently.
Like, there's that way, too.
Yeah, well, I guess we're going down here.
Get some pictures of us on the bridge.
Mm-hmm. Wait, look, there's part of a creek down there. Oh, but yeah, there was, like, in the pageant last night, like... No, what I was saying, you know how in the pageant last night they were, like, getting leeches and stuff on them?
Yeah.
That actually happened. Like, oh. Delora, she got a bunch of leeches on her. Wait, what's that?
On the banks of Plum Creek Rock.
Wait up, Donna. Up here's the dugout, right? Or what's left of it.
Adorable, are they not? Yes. And I mean, they're really, really cool. And it, we didn't get to work together very much because I like left in season 7 and they were came in then. But then when I came back for the return of Nellie, the episode where I was hanging with Nancy and everything, we had a party and it was really awesome. I had this purple dress and there was a cake and everything. And they were actually in that scene. So I did technically get to do one scene with them. But mostly in that episode, I was not hanging with the Carters because I was doing all that stuff with my evil sister, Nancy, who was awesome, who's Alison.
Were they all one take or did it take multiple times and did you get hurt or anything?
Okay, so the question was, in Alden's Dilemma, when Reverend Alden has a little competition in town, because, as you know, the young Reverend Hale comes to town and is surprising him with a home of his own, and so he doesn't find that out to the end of the show, so there's a lot of mystery going on, and Victor French has been spying on Melissa and I, cleaning up this new house, getting it ready for the Reverend. And so he thinks, as he's hearing Reverend Hale from inside, you know this, I shouldn't be telling you what you already know, the poetry that he's reading and the things that he's hearing on one-sided through a window, he's making up, of course, the idea of that there's some shady going on. So when he really approaches us with it and I finally realize how could he think that of me and of Melissa and how dare he think that, I go after him and I hit him, and he told me, because I was doing it very lightly. He said, "No, you hit me. Hit me, hit me. Just go in." You know, he says, "I can take this," and he could. Of course, he could take it. So he let me really go after him, and I didn't do it very long. He says, "No, keep going, just keep hitting me." And we did take after take after take, which is what the question was did you just do it one time, and that's good? Yeah, no. Some things are one time, like blowing up the town was one time.
Yeah.
But, not that.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you for the question.
Sure.
Thank you.